I've finally done it, guys. I've reviewed Lazy, and in today's video, I'm gonna share my unfiltered thoughts about whether this is any good. So if you've been watching this channel for any portion of time, you'll know that I love new apps. I check them out all the time, and I'm hopefully going to be diving into more of them soon. And Lazy is one that's been on my list for some time. It helps you to capture notes and tasks on Mac in a keyboard-friendly way. And today I'm gonna share my thoughts on it, and I think the best place to start is the pricing. Now this app, Lazy, is not free. It's $15 per month. For annual pricing, it's $150, which is $30 off annually. And this one is limited to Mac only. It is also has an iOS app, which I demoed just there, but it's more of a capture app, and it's only available through the test flight version, which is updated every 90 days. So once you commit and you pay your $15, you get two ways to get started, a guided way or a self-serve way. The guided way, you book a call with somebody to onboard. You don't actually pay your subscription until you've had that call and you've fully onboarded. The self-serve way starts your subscription straight away and gets you thrown in. Now you have to enable access for accessibility because this app is going to be downloaded on Mac and will allow you to essentially capture stuff whilst you're on your Chrome browser or other browsers and quickly capture things too. It also requires Apple Script support for automation hookups as well. So that's just something to note, as well as using the Lazy AI features that I'll bring in later on. So before we watch this review, if you're interested in Lazy, you can download it below. You can check it out, you'll find a link there. And our video today is kindly sponsored by SunSama. It's a powerful way to do weekly planning and you'll absolutely love it for your task management. Check it out in the link in the description if you're interested. So what does this app even do? Well, it's quite cool in the sense that it looks absolutely gorgeous. The app is really sleek, really clean, and it does three core things. Allows you to capture your notes fast, allows you to capture your tasks fast, and has a journal feature for writing down journal entries or bringing together your tasks or notes, and a search area for being able to find stuff for later. Now, underpinning all of this, it's keyboard orientated, meaning you can browse all of the account and basically use your keyboard for the whole amount of it. Now, I didn't learn all of the features, but I got to grips with a few of them, like the ability to quickly open it up and save something wherever you are. So very simply, if you're in a YouTube video, an article, a tweet, you can capture that context, or you can just capture a particular highlighted bit of text. Now, it's really useful because you can do this across your account and save anything as a note or a task. And this is great because you can add more detail to it, and you can add more context to each of them. So you can have things like authors, published dates, and much, much more. Now, everything that you capture lands in either one of two areas, unless you state that, notes or tasks. And you can even split these inboxes, as they're called, up using a split inbox feature like you would see in apps like Superhuman. And it's very interesting because this split inbox feature is a great way to capture things like if you want to bring an article in, a YouTube video in, or something that resonates with a particular topic that you're researching right now. You can do the same with tasks, and tasks can then be organized into different areas that you need to get done and complete. So very much like an email inbox, you can process everything and things belong into later, done, and trash. And this is where your all cards area lives, which means you can come back and search for any note at any given time. Now, each note you open up, you can use Lazy's AI to do summaries and other such things like rephrasing things or retitling or whatever you typically do with AI right now. It depends whether you want to change the tone of the text all the way to generating certain tags or explaining using the AI prompts, which you can access and change inside of your settings area. As I mentioned earlier, there's a journal area in which you can see all of your dates that you've added items to. And that's particularly useful because you can see a bit of a GitHub commits demonstration at the top, meaning you can see all of the days that you've submitted to, and it's quite a nice visual representation, as well as being this gorgeous note that you can pin and use keyboard shortcuts to quickly browse through. The other thing that you can do is you can go into any note that is a full capture of the tweet, article, or whatever you captured, meaning you can bring the whole context along with you. You can open that as a full reader experience, meaning you can break that down and be able to see that. I'll come back to that later because that's quite funny what happened here. Now, the idea of this application is to remove the friction from saving things, whether that's your tasks or your notes. And that idea is very, very good. You can use the AI and bake it into capturing that, or you can not use it and basically capture stuff really, really quickly, still in that manner. Whilst I was testing on Chrome, it worked very well being able to save articles and be able to bring that insight into the account. And I quite liked how smooth the application was in terms of being able to use the keyboard shortcut. So today's video is sponsored by Sensama. Sensama is a powerful, mindful task management software, and it's really popular for those who want to stand back and plan their day more effectively. There's guided planning, reflection upon each of the days that you complete, and great systems in place to help you focus, but also make sure you're not stuffing your calendar and task management with lots and lots of tasks. So check out Sensama below, and thanks for those guys for sponsoring today's video. Now, it's strange. This application sort of wants to be a blend between Raycast and something like Reflect Notes. Reflect Notes being an application that is well known for being AI note-taking orientated and helps you bring in stuff like Kindle takeaways and things like that, highlights that you want to bring in, which also this application does. And also, it sort of feels like Raycast in the sense that it is very keyboard orientated and connects deeply with your Chrome browser and whatever browser that you're using right now. It looks a lot like Superhuman, and its interactions on onboarding is incredibly similar. In terms of being able to set it up, it does look like a very attractive application. Now, this sort of brings me to some of the pros and cons. Now, as I mentioned there, I really do like the design. The entire experience is really nice. Don't get me wrong, that isn't something to worry about. It is really nice for just browsing. I also like how fast the keyboard capture works as well, especially when you're on Chrome, but does require you to get used to the keyboard shortcuts. For me, that takes time, but for many others, it will be a breeze. I also like how the AI is well set up as well. It's not overly dense in features, but it does have some good setup. Despite being able to only be able to edit a few AI prompts in your settings, it's quite good for being able to bring stuff up. The only thing it doesn't have is seemingly the global AI search. For example, if you added a bunch of journal entries, it's not able to condense that bulk input, like what was my last 20 days like in terms of mood or emotions. Could be quite helpful in terms of that. So in terms of my cons, the application was a little bit inconsistent. So I found the speed was good in some times, but other times it was actually quite slow. So for example, I was using this and jumping between it for about an hour, and I had a good 15 minute stint, and then a bad 5 minute stint, and then a good 15 minute stint, and a bad 5 minute stint. I don't know what it was, but it almost seems like if I was running something in the background that was slightly pressing the RAM speed or the computer speed, then it basically slowed down because of that. And that for me wasn't particularly a good experience. Superhuman, in which I compare this application to just a lot because it's trying to be that speed orientated app, I never really have many issue with compared to what I did with this application. In terms of the performance, I found it a little bit laggy. There was also one notable bug. For example, when I was on a reader page and I opened into that reader page and the videos were inside of the article, it opened all of the videos at the same time. I'm not sure this is a known bug, but it was almost like that scene from Finding Nemo, where I was just like, mine, with me talking about 300 times, and it was terrifying. Here's a quick clip of that. So you can see what I mean there. So the performance was slightly strange, and I did note as well that I did have a 5 minute slow time after I encountered that bug. So it could have been that I overloaded the system myself and then caused that problem by that bug. But just my awareness is that I found the performance not as what I think it does market itself as, if that makes sense. So the iOS version is really limited to just this just a screen that demonstrates what's jot something down, which is a big send button, and a audio capture or scan text feature. That is it. You can't browse your notes, you can't read them on the go, you can't do anything like that, which is a bit of a shame. And also, it being on test flight sort of feels half-baked. I know other apps that do this, but in my opinion, it's not fully put together well in terms of the iOS version. I can imagine a lot of people would love to be able to use this on the mobile, but they're limited to the mobile web version. Okay. Here's my verdict. Well, I think this is a gorgeous looking notes app. It is fantastic the way that it looks, and actually it impressed me with the fact that it had more note orientated stuff than I thought it did. Some people commented on the actual ability to write notes. Actually didn't find that a problem. The way that you can use the journal feature was pretty decent. You can tag stuff, you can write, and it was just a generally nice experience. And if you're using it for that, I actually think it's pretty decent. The capture features work well, but the performance is something that definitely was a big bugbear for me, especially if you're paying $15 per month. Now, I know a couple of other apps who charge round about that pricing, and the experience is slightly better than this. For example, if I had to compare it directly to another note-taking app that's like it, Reflect Notes, priced at $10 per month, granted billed annually, but $5 less than the likes of this app, and in my opinion, the overall experience is much tidier, faster, and reliable than something like this. So I'd probably say that right now it should lower its pricing, but that's obviously not part of the review. But I think it should continue to refine those performance things. Maybe I was a set use case. Maybe I'm gonna see in the comments that the experience wasn't like this for them and they've had a rapidly fast layout. I recently did a big removal of memory dragging things from my device via Clean My Mac and manually, and it still didn't have a big impact on the speed. So I was just very curious of this. I think this application has a lot of promise. I really like the premium design. I love the keyboard focus, and when it works, it was nice. But when I found that it didn't, it was just annoying. So if you want a beautiful looking keyboard first Mac capture app, this could be it. It's obviously struggling in some of the performance speeds, but it has promise. And I think that is a great starting point. So thanks very much for stopping by on today's video. Make sure to check out all the tools over on toolfinder.co. There's loads of new ones popping up, so do check it out there. And if you want 3 new tools in your inbox every week, you'll find a link there as well to our newsletter. Thanks very much, folks, and I'll see you very soon. Cheerio for now.